Right, 30 seconds on the clock, Peter, and your time starts now. Who was the manager the last time Scotland men's team beat England?
Oh, and Craig Brown.
In what year did Scottish fans invade the Wembley pitch and break the crossbar?
1981.
Who was the last Scottish player to score two goals against England in a single game?
Lee Griffiths.
True or false, Steve Clarke's got a better win percentage than Gareth Southgate?
True.
Who was the last English player to score two goals against Scotland in a single game?
Harry Kane.
Who famously did keepy uppies during the game when Scotland became unofficial world champions in 1967?
Jim Baxter.
Okay, let's bring Mark Wilson back. Mark, can you hear us?
Yeah.
What's up with you?
Did you listen to any of that, or were you just listening to music?
I was just listening to Tina Turner.
That's the first I've ever seen that. Like the other contestant.
Does the other pundit usually take their headphones
take
off?
Take their headphones off. But I turned to Roger to kind of get a gauge of how things were going. If he's got, he's just nodding his head about Tina Turner.
He likes to listen live.
Why wouldn't you listen?
Well, I just listen live and sort of play along in my own head.
That's weird.
Ready?
Okay.
30 seconds starts now.
Right.
Who was the manager the last time the Scotland men's team beat England?
Oh, Craig Brown.
In what year did Scottish fans invade the Wembley pitch and break the crossbar?
67.
Who was the last Scottish player to score two goals against England in a single game?
Griffiths.
True or false, Steve Clarke has a better win percentage than Gareth Southgate?
True.
Who was the last English player to score two goals against Scotland in a single game?
Kane.
Who famously did keepy uppies during the game when Scotland became unofficial and named the only player in the current Scotland squad who's scored against England?
Oh,
3-2-1. Yeah. Okay, Peter, how do you think it went?
Oh, Robertson.
Oh no! You be quiet.
Sorry, Peter.
You'll get your chance, Peter.
He'll get his cards.
Sorry, how do you think it went, Peter?
He got the same one Ryan had, so I think it's
pretty close. Yeah, it was pretty close. Craig Brown was the manager, Wembley 1999. You both got it. Roger, breaking of the crossbar.
77.
You know, my dad was there as well.
Yeah, there we go. Lee Griffiths, last player to score two in the single game. You both sort of fell for it as well. And maybe this is a little sign of the mindset. Scotland are good and they're doing well, but Gareth Southgate's got a better win percentage. Yeah. They very rarely lose games, especially not qualification games. So 62.4% for Gareth Southgate, 52 for Steve Clarke. So you're all getting carried away. The last English player to score two goals against Scotland in a single game. If I gave you more time, Peter, would you get it now?
No, I wouldn't.
It was Paul Scholes.
No.
It was the
I was at the body of the game.
There you go, typical.
I thought Wayne Rooney.
Ooh, in the Celtic Park game.
Yeah.
Oh, you might be right, actually. Did he get it too? Doesn't, well, none of you got it right anyway.
Not sure.
Maybe because it's a friendly we've raised, I don't know. Anyway, who famously did the keepy uppies? It was Jim Baxter. Well done, you both got it. So we're level on 3-all. Here's the thing, Peter. He got one more question than you, right?
Yeah.
And the question was, name the only player in the current Scotland squad to score against England. Now, if only his boss for the charity that he works for was the answer to this question. Andy Robertson, Celtic Park. You come in here every night wearing the tracksuit, showing it off to everyone. You've not got it on
as well. I had it on as well when I took off.
P45 is in the post, Wilson.
Sorry, Gaffer.
Luckily for you, he's probably busy, and I don't think he'll be listening.
He'll be tied up
unless they've got us on in the.
He'll watch the rerun later.
I'm sure he does. He never misses it, apparently. So
I'm not getting that.
There we go. Right. So
what is that tiebreaker?
It is a tiebreaker. Right. Okay. Terrible. Right. What I'm going to do is going to read the question. I'll get Mark to write it down. I'll then invite you to give me your attempt, Peter. Okay.
No problem.
Question: before tonight, how many games have Scotland won against England? Mark Wilson. In the history of the fixture, how many games have Scotland men's team won against England? Write it down, please. Hurry up. Okay. And Peter?
27.
27, says Peter. Mark Wilson says 15. I know we've been bad, but we're not that bad. It is 41. Well done to you, Peter. The signed ball is on its way to Hamilton. Good man.
Yes, cheers.
Well done, Peter. What would you have gone?
Good work, Peter.
I actually went a wee bit higher. I actually went 58.
You would have been amazed, you know, that way that your old sparring partner in here, Mr. DL. You know, if he gets a bit lazy on the job, because he's used to being next to you on here, or he's used to being next to you. But if he's got like a new pundit alongside him, he tries to show off.
Aye.
He was reading out all these stats about Scotland and England games last night, I think to impress Andy Halliday. And he had the number of wins that Scotland had right. in the fixture. He was bang on form last night.
He's just texting.
Is he listening,
me.
Is he?
Aye, but I can't read.
On a Tuesday night, let me see. I'll try and paraphrase.
I don't know why.
Yeah, very good. Yep. Rhymes with brick for anyone that's paying attention. Moving on quickly. 01419511025.
Is he calling me that or the caller Peter?
Presumably you. Why would it be?
I don't know. After Peter hung up, he texts me. Thanks for listening.
Since we're on the subject of stats, 4 defeats in a row.
Ah, for me.
Are you serious?
I know.
Are you serious?
I'm having a nightmare. Roger, when you were away, it all
4
went wrong.
Defeats in a row.
Pretty, I must be bottom of the table. Huh? Oh. And all of them are tiebreakers, I think. No, 2 of them are tiebreakers.
Horrific. Really bad. Really bad, I must
bad
say.
Bad form. I'd be sacked if this was the footballing world.
Yes.
I was a manager, I would have been indeed. Sacked after 4
if Andy
games.
Robertson is listening, you will be.